In this video, we are going to answer the questions, what is a module? And why is it the best practice to organize your course using modules? Modules organize your course content in a linear progression and provide a simple step-by-step sequence for your students to follow. You can organize your modules by weeks, chapters, units. Modules allow you to track student progress, create prerequisite activities, and show all of your course content in one place. Think of a module as a content delivery system. Content consists of pages, quizzes, assignments, discussions, files, as well as web links. The module is a container for this and allows you as the instructor to decide when and how this content will be released to the student. If you choose to use modules, we recommend that you hide all other Canvas tools from the course menu. For example, if all of your assignments, quizzes, and pages are listed in the modules, then you don't need to show them on the course navigation. This also helps keep the navigation bar clear and distinct with easily identifiable labels. Early research shows that people have clear limits in the amount of information they can process. So having a concise menu will help in lowering the amount of information overload. Don't just take our word for it. Here are what students and instructors have to say about why they like the module structure.
Modules are a way for us to categorize bits of learning into knowable pieces. Formerly did units, but really I do modules now, which operate very similarly, and it's a good way to communicate themes of learning in world history for me.
My child abuse and neglect class is structured where we do chapter-based reviews off of our textbook, and it's actually been like really helpful in making sure that everything is consistent. It's been working out really well, and it's been really good at helping me keep up with my different chapters and studies and stuff like that.
I like that structure because you can keep up with everything and it's all there, posted at once and anything like that, and you can go ahead if you want to, or if you're kind of behind, you can reread your chapters and anything like that.
So I had a class that would, for each week, have the description, and then it would have the assignment, the discussion post, and then where you would turn in the questions for the week. So that was really nice because every week you'd go in and you could start reading and you could start doing everything, and it was separate so you wouldn't get lost because you could go in and click directly on what you needed to do and see exactly what the professor described and what he wanted out of each assignment. So that was really nice.
Canvas is nice having a module because then you can get rid of the thing on the side that says discussion. So if you have discussion, right, you want to keep the list on the left as simple as possible. So if you put everything in a module, then they know. But the students like it. I mean, like the organization of the module.
At first it was a bit hard to get used to, but after a while, like, I got the flow of it. It's pretty organized.
So by having the week modules, I like that a lot because I know exactly what I need to finish the homework or the quiz. It also helps me with time management.
I do it weekly, but within units. That way that the students just kind of have a nice, organized, clear list of moving one assignment to the next, and it fits my due dates better.
We hope this has encouraged you to give modules a try in your course. If you need help setting up modules, email Distance Learning. Thank you for taking the time to watch and find out why we think using modules is the best practice.